أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين وصل على محمد في الآخرين وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خير for coming and بارك الله فيكم and ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى by His great name to make it an hour balance in front of Allah عز وجل. Going on with the greatness of Allah سبحانه وتعالى in Arabic العظمة. And the word al-azama with the roots and the يعني مشتقات of it in القرآن الكريم alone more than 100 times about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as I said, after the prayers and explaining that you should know who is He, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the conditions of la ilaha illallah to enter Islam and to be continuously Muslim, you have to know Allah. You have to know everything about Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything available in Quran and Sunnah. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide us. Because some of the things you cannot. For that, very important to know who is Allah. When He wants something, only kun, kaf and noon. Two letters. And it will be as He wants, with the time He wants, at the place He wants, with the way He wants, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Powerful, unlimited, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Knowledge, unlimited, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to know about the actions of Allah. Allah can use the same thing for safety and for destruction, for good and for bad, same. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, power. Example of that I give the last time. We know the story of Sayyidina Musa. When he was going and the soldier of him, or the mu'mineen with another way with him, the believers with him, was running away from Fir'aun and his actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, just hit the sea. Allah make the sea change like the mountains. And the way, because we know that bottom of the sea is muddy, cannot walk in it, and very deep. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His greatness, He make it for them a very good road and very dry. Allah saved them with the water. Just they left. Sayyidina Musa want to hit the sea again in order for the sea to be closed. He doesn't want Fir'aun to come. Allah said, no, leave it. Leave it. Innahum mughraqoon. Allah used the same thing for Fir'aun and his soldier to kill all of them. Destroy all of them. Out of their arrogance and out of their disobeying and out of their going against Allah and His Messenger. For that, لا يسأل عما يفعل وهم يسألون. He never be questioned, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But every one of us will be questioned, will be asked. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask us about everything. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is a merciful, but He have a punishment. He get pleased, but He get angry also. He love the believers, but He dislike the kuffar, the disbeliever. He see, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He hear. He is al-khaliq, the creator, from nothing. And He is al-raziq. Billions of people and birds and animals, different kind, everywhere. Who gives them rizq? Themself is impossible. Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who give. Allah is the one who give you some test. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who remove the hardship you have. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who guide, the one who have a pure heart, and the one who wants the guidance, and who wants the love of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide him. At the same time, Allah is the one also mislead the one who wants to be misleaded. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will lead the one who doesn't want Allah, doesn't want Rasulullah, go. Allah does not force nobody, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the one who give. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who prevent. Stop. subhanahu wa ta'ala. Able to do whatever he want, by the way he want, at the time he want, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Glory be to him. At the same time, is there one thing can make him busy of another thing? No. For us, yes. If you are busy with one, you cannot do the other one. And if you do two things, you will not be able to do both of them perfectly. Impossible. For Allah, not. لا يشغله شأن عن شأن. Nothing can make Allah busy from another thing. Impossible. Look how many millions of different languages. We know some of it. A majority we don't know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala understands it. And Allah also the one who created subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. Say, He is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one, the self-sufficient master subhanahu wa ta'ala. And look to the stories of the messengers. And I stopped the last time with the story of some of the messengers. I already said it about Sayyidina Ibrahim, Sayyidina Nuh, Sayyidina Isa, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we know some of the stories of the messenger, some of it mentioned in Quran al-Kareem, some of it mentioned in Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also, brothers, if all of us become so good and so pious and so real believers and real worshippers to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, does it benefit Allah? Does this benefit Allah azza wa jal? No. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, hadith Qudsi. Allah say, Ya ibadi, O my worshipper. لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم. If all of you, from beginning till the end, from the first one till the last, human being and jinn together, كانوا على أتقى قلب رجل واحد منكم. Become like the most pious and righteous and worshipper and the best of them, all. Become like united and all of them worshipper to Allah. ما زاد ذلك في ملك شيئا. It will never increase the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything. With another way, it will never benefit Allah in nothing. It will benefit us. Allah make it for us out of His mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also opposite in the same hadith. يا عبادي لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أفجار قلب رجل واحد منكم ما نقص ذلك من ملك شيئا. If all of you from beginning till the end, one by one, become together, human being and jinn, become the most evil, and disbelievers, it will never decrease the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing. It will not harm Allah in anything. It will harm you. For that your taqwa will benefit you. And will benefit also your own kids, your own offspring. At-taqwa tanfa'u dhurriya. Taqwa will benefit you and benefit your offspring after you. Evil and wrong and disobeying and being far from Allah and forget about Him completely, doesn't know nothing about Him, does not study nothing about Allah Azza wa Jal, also, it will never harm Allah, it will harm you. Also, treasures of Allah never end. And do not think that treasures of Allah is only the earth. No. Now we come to know the earth and whatever around it, of all kind of planets, all together, moon and sun and Pluto and Neptune and I don't know what else, too many. All of it, now we come to know, together, in the very wide and very huge space, is like one sand in a very huge desert. All of this kingdom of who? Of Allah. Treasures of who? Of Allah. Who controls that and make it to go with the arrangement and with the system? Allah Azza wa Jal. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody else can do anything. For that if the whole earth and whatever and it even become so evil and gone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is not the only thing He has. No. But at the same time, as Allah Azza wa Jal say, from His greatness, look to the greatness of Allah. Oh my worshipper. And look to how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala respect us. And how He call us. My ibad. A very beautiful name. Oh my worshipper. لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قال مقام كلهم في صعيد واحد. فسألوني فأعطيت كل واحد منهم مسألته ما نقص ذلك مما عندي. إِلَّا كَمَا يَنْقُصُ الْمَخْيَطُ إِذَا يُدْخِلَ فِي الْبَحْرِ. If all of you together, from beginning till the end, human being and jinn, males and females, come and standing in front of Allah all in one, and everyone ask whatever he want completely, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it all of them, whatever they want, it will never decrease the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will never decrease the khazain, the treasures of Allah, except like the needle. Look to the example Allah gave. Do you know of the needle? The one you sew your clothes with it, put it in a ocean. What will reduce? It will never reduce nothing. If Allah, after he answer every single one of us, human being and jinn, according to what they want, and give it to them, it will never reduce the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Except like whatever the needle reducing from the ocean. Nothing, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Powerful, azama, greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about the reward, the good deeds. When you do good deeds and Allah reward you for it. Look to the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One good deed, he give you 10, start with 10 good remarks. 10 good reward you will take. Does not start from one. One should be by one. Allah make it one good deed, one prayer, 10. Till 700. Till 1 million. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply to whom he will by the way he want more and more. Unlimited. This is with one good deed you do. With one good deed only you do. Suppose even you want to do a good deed, but you didn't do it. You want to do a good deed, but you did not do it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still, only because of the intention you want to do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write it to you a full good deed. Just have intention to do. Allah will write it to you a full good deed. And Allah multiply also to you if you have intention and you really try to do it. With the good deeds like that, with the bad deeds. If it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of his greatness saying that good deed start from 10, bad deed start from 10, no. Bad deed will be written to you only one bad deed from the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that. And if you have intention to do the bad deed, but you did not do it out of the fear of Allah, love to Allah, on the good deed, if you even only just want to do, but you didn't do, it will be written to you a good deed, right? If you want to do a bad deed and you did not do it, should be written. Because for the good deed written without doing, this should be written without doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no, he will write it to you, yes. But he will write it to you a good deed, that you prevent yourself from it. Look to the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is good and he loves every good one. He wants you to be good. He calling you to Jannah. What more than this? What more than this? There is a question come at that point. If it is with this goodness, one good deed, multiply a lot, and one bad deed will be reduced and will be only one by one. This is one by 10 and 1 700 for the good, and one by million and one by billions. And this is, will be only one by one. How? Either one of two. Some people will go hell. How? Either one of two. He doesn't do any good at all. Or if he did it, he does not do it according to his mind, excellent and perfect. No. According to the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah, something missing. Remember when I said he do good deed, but show off. Will be acceptable, will never be acceptable. Do good deed while not a believer. He does not believe in Allah, does not believe in Rasulullah, does not believe in Quran, does not want to follow. Then he lost it, even his good. Also, he do a good deed according to his own mind, not according to the Quran and Sunnah. Come to the fard, leave it, and do the voluntary according to his own way, thinking this will replace that. No. For that, if still with this, somebody will go, yes, either the bad deeds become more than the good, or the good he do is not perfect and complete according to the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. He did salah, but for show off. Zakah or sadaqah, for show off. It will never be acceptable. Even it is still good. Good comes according to the Quran and Sunnah, but not according to the sincerity to Allah, which in Arabic, ikhlas to Allah. For that missing one of the condition of accepting the good deeds, this is a dangerous one. Because you did good, but still you are not going. Why? You are missing some of the condition for that good deeds. For that, must be the good deeds with the condition of it in order to take that reward. 10, 700, 1 million, and multiplying. And this is also, again, is not only at the time of doing. Because suppose I did a very good deed, and I know, alhamdulillah, sincerely, but later I show off with it. Later I mention it for the people. Khalas, you burn it. Now, do you have that good deed? No. If you do the same with other, become now your bad, become more than good. Look to what Allah says in the hadith. Whoever give a sadaqah, even equal to a date fruit. Even equal to a date fruit. But min kasbin tayyib, a condition here. Min kasbin tayyib, from halal income. Must be. Halal means halal. Everybody knows it. Even you will argue about it, you should avoid it. Even there is a doubt. Imam al-Bukhari, one of the reasons of the acceptance of Allah to his Sahih al-Bukhari, not only him, his own father used to say, by Allah, I don't know any one dinar, in our own language, $1 in my money, not only haram, no. He does not say haram. He does not even say, have a shubha. I have a doubt about it. Does not even have one dinar of all of my money from beginning. This is his father. Of all of my money from beginning till the end, have even a doubt. Shubha, a doubt about it. Means sure, 100% from beginning till the end, completely haram. Halal, astaghfirullah. Completely halal from beginning till the end. This is the reason Allah make his son, al-Bukhari, having all of this, with others, I'm not denying, too many other good qualities he was having. As I was talking about him, that 10 ulama, of the very great ulama at his time, some of these 10 ulama, alims of the hadith, professional in hadith, all of them, was his own teacher. And everyone, as a test, it was not as a challenge. Test to him, mention to him 10 ahadith to see why all of these millions of people lift us and go to him. Let us test this man. Really, he is a alim or not? Every single one mentioned to him 10 hadith, mixed of the series of it, of the chain, silsila, chain of it, and mixing of the text. And one time only. First one, he say his 10. Second one, he say his 10. Third one, he say his 10. 10, 10, 10. Total is 100 hadith. Not write chain, silsila, not write the text of it. And they are alims. It's not like me and you know some and doesn't know some. No. A big and huge. And he hear it, one. Then, for the first one, he say to him, you mention so and so. He mentioned to him what he mentioned firstly. He does not mention the correction. Mention to him what you said so and so and so. Yes, yes. And this is the thing you say. Yes. The first hadith is wrong and the right is so and so. Second hadith, so and so. Third, fourth, four, 10. Finished. Second one, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 90, 80, 90, 100. Subhanallah. 100 ways. Correction of, firstly he mentioned to them what they say, then after that, he mentioned to them the correction of it, from one time, subhanallah. This is the greatness of Allah, and this is a gift from whom? It's not because of al-Bukhari himself, from Allah Azza wa Jal. But also comes to a good land. Come to, I mean exactly a good heart, pure heart, clean heart, connected to Allah Azza wa Jal. Knows who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they have يعني the knowledge, the real knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his book, the Quran, and from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, just a small sadaqah from a good kasbun tayyib, good earning, halal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply it to you until it becomes, this small one will become like the mountain. Another example, a man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with a camel. This is what he have, a camel. Said, ya Rasulullah, this is for a sadaqah for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, لَكَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ سَبْعُ مَاءَةُ نَاقَةٍ مَخْطُومَةٍ. you will have in the day of Qiyamah because of that 700 camels. 700 camels in Al-Jannah, inshaAllah. What? Why? Because of that sincerity. Those people, they know who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those people, they know who is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They sacrifice the dunya for the deen. They do not sacrifice the deen for the dunya. They sacrifice some of the dunya, not all, but some of the dunya for the sake of Allah, for the sake of their deen, their religion. They never ever sacrifice anything of their religion because of the dunya or for the sake of the dunya. For that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from His greatness, creator of the heavens and the earth, who creates the darkness and the light, light of the sun, and the light we don't know, many other lights, and the darkness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the shade and the place unshaded, under the sun and not and the shade, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who creates the life and the death, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who enlarge and provide rizq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who from the greatness of Allah, who resurrect whoever in the graves? Who is able to do that other than Allah? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who makes the land alive after die? The land as we die, the land dies sometimes. There is no rain, you will find it cracked and dead. Allah sends the rain. Who make it life, not the rain? Allah azza wa jalla subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who will make it easy for you? And who will also give you some test of some difficulties? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who can make that easy to be continuously, and who can make that hardship to go away? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who sent the Quran and the explanation of the Quran? Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal, who sent the messengers with the glad tidings and with the warning? Wrong way. To be all the time, and this is one of our own people, want me to be all the time praising. Impossible, ya akhi. Quran itself, give glad tidings and give warning also. Talking about the Jannah, talking about the Nar. Talking about the good deeds, talking about the bad deeds of the people. Or is it impossible for any Imam or for any Alim to be all the time praising and only mentioning every good only? Doesn't mention anything about any punishment? No. In Quran itself contains both, which Allah revealed it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who sends the angel, like Jibreel, to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and other angels? We know the story from the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who revealed the Quran and the Torah and the Injil? Alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah revealed the Quran as also shifa and rahmah. Shifa, cure, healing, and also mercy. Wallahi by Allah, every single letter, I'm not saying every single word or ayah in the Quran. Even in every single letter in the Quran, al-Kareem, have a wisdom in it, have a barakah in it, have a blessing from Allah in it, have a solution to some of our own problems. But if we are related to it, if we are understanding, if we try really to apply it in our own life, if all of us knows what Allah wants, as I said in the khutbah yesterday, not only the dead is the one whose soul get out. No. It could be somebody is alive. Alive means he's moving and talking and walking and everything. But he's dead. If he doesn't know what Allah wants from him. If he doesn't know the right of Allah upon you. If you know what is the right of Allah upon you and you do accordingly, then alhamdulillah, you are saved. Alhamdulillah. You are alive. Your heart is alive. Your heart is pure. Your heart is clean. Your heart is connected to Allah. But if it is not, do not blame anybody else. And the only chance in this world. The only chance in this world. For that, in al-hukmu illa lillah. Judgment in hand of Allah alone. Wa masabru illa billah. Sabr from Allah and by Allah. From Allah Azza wa Jalla is the one who can give it to you, nobody else. And by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means you seek the help from Him by Him. وَمَا التَّوَكُّلُ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ Depend only upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Love must be for Allah Azza wa Jal. And even if you love somebody in the dunya for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, and if you hate his behavior only for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one who saves us from every calamity. Who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. The one who removes the bad and removes the evil and removes the hardship. Who accept your dua? Answer me. Allah Azza wa Jal only. His saying is the truth. And his order and his promise, no doubt will happen. And his judgment is right. All the kingdom in his hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the praises in his hand. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Heavens and earth and whatever is his kingdom, subhanahu wa ta'ala. His mercy. He sent in this land, out of his mercy, only one part. 99, according to the hadith, kept with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 99 part. And out of this part in the dunya, in the land, all the creation become merciful to each other because of that. Out of that only. Greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But at the same time, he is the creator of al-Jannah. And he has the merciful, he creator also of Jahannam. And he has the punishment in it. And severe punishment to the one who doesn't want to listen. To the one who doesn't want to believe. To the one who doesn't want to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Out of the greatness of Allah, who brings the dead from the life. And for the life from the dead. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who makes the sun giving the light continuously, billions of years. Anybody able to do? Nobody at all. Who makes this light of the sun and the moon also? Who makes the night dark and for a rest? Who makes the day also for living? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said in Surah Al-Mu'minun, ayah number 14, فَتَبَارَكَ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ الْخَالِقِينَ. Blessed is Allah, the best of the creator. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. الَّذِي أَحْسَنَ Surah Al-Sajda. Ayah number 17. Ayah number 7. الَّذِي أَحْسَنَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who made everything, he has created the best. Who made everything he has created is the best. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in Surah Luqman, out of his greatness. Ayah number 11. هَذَا خَلْقُ اللَّهِ فَأَرُونِي مَاذَا خَلَقَ الَّذِينَ مِن دُونِهِ. This is the creation of Allah. Show me any other one can create. Can create anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenged them. Greatness of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Look to the creation of Allah with the difference of it. Of it. Human being and jinn we cannot see. And that thing is already no more. Dinosaurs and all of this huge. Who created? Who make it to go? Allah Azza wa Jalla. Camels, and look to the creation of the camel and how it is suitable to the desert. Subhanallah. Impossible for anybody. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they will not be able even to create a fly. Fly. And not only that, if this fly taken away from them something, they will not be able to take it back. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who sent the rain from the sky? Allah Azza wa Jal. We believe in the one who controls the reasons. If you see the forecast and saying to you, low pressure, high pressure, this and that, cold weather, hot weather, meeting each other, must be rain. Don't believe them. We are not denying the reason. But we are saying the one who controls this reason is Allah. And nothing will happen except by permission of Allah, by the will of Allah. Because everything in his hand could be all of this reason. Allah doesn't want any rain to come down. It will never. And it could be no any reason. And Allah wants to send the rain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send it. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was standing in the minbar, one of the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a man came complaining, Ya Rasulullah, already we are going to die. No any kind of rain. No any water for drinking. Our own animal die. The plant is no more any plant. The land become dead. Just subhanallah. Rasulullah raised his hand and asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right away. No now low pressure and high pressure. No now cold weather and hot weather. No anything at all. Only just Allah wanted to come down. And the Sahabi said, we looked around. There was no anything, no any cloud. No any. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it. And the whole week, They say from the Jum'ah till the Jum'ah, second Jum'ah after it, whole week we never see the sun. Until the same man, or the hadith saying, a different man came, Ya Rasulullah, a lot of rain. And we will be, يعني, our house is destroyed and become flood. And we cannot live. Rasulullahum hawalayna wa la alayna. Oh Allah, make it around us, not upon us. Right away. Is it as if there was a hole over the Medina and was the rain around it and no any rain coming inside? Who can do that other than Allah Azza wa Jal? Nobody at all, from the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The plant. Did you see the huge trees? How started this huge tree? A very small seed, right? Who make it to grow? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who make different, millions of different kind of fruits and vegetables? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And who makes the taste of it completely different? At the same time, as Allah mentioned in Quran al-Kareem, same land and same water. Right or wrong? Same land, but same water. And different. This is different than this. Different of color, different of taste, different of smell, different of everything. Even the shape, the size. Subhanallah. Glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kun, fayakun. Be and it is. It is as he wants. By the way he wants. At the time he won, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Talking about us himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying that he created you with the best shape. الذي, Surah Al-Infitar, Surah number 82, Ayah number 7. الذي خلقك فسواك فعدلك في أي صورة ما شاء ركبك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who fashioned you. Fashioned you perfectly. And he give you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, a due proportion. In whatever form he willed, he put you together. Who shaped you with this way? And able to walk upon two legs. If Allah doesn't want, you'll never be able. Some people will ask Allah save us, say Ameen. They will walk upon their faces. And they ask the Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, how we will walk upon our faces? Rasulullah answered very great, Subhanallah. He said, الَّذِي أَمْشَاهُمْ عَلَىٰ قَدَمَيْهِمْ قَادْرٌ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يُمْشِيهِمْ عَلَىٰ وُجُوهِمْ. The one who make you to able to walk upon your leg is the same one who is able to make you walk upon your face. Some of the creation of Allah walking upon their bellies. Their belly, no legs, no nothing. Because we think that must be a legs in order to walk. No. Snakes walking upon what? Upon their belly. And subhanallah, who make him to walk upon his bellies? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some of the snake faster than us. I don't remember exactly. Not the cobra. There is another one live always in the South Africa, in the south part. Mamba. This is, it goes 40 miles. 40 miles. So fast. Faster than the human being. Abun the belly. Subhanallah. And not only abun the land. It could be abun the trees and from a tree to another tree. Subhanallah. Glory be to Allah. Allah is the one who do everything. But be related to him. And believe me by Allah. If you are really connected to Allah, Ya Rabbi, congratulations to you. Congratulations, really. And this is what Allah name al-wali. Awliyaullah. La khawfun alayhim, wa lahum yahzanun. No fear about them, don't worry about them. And them themselves never feel sad or bad or grief. Because they are connected to the one who, in his hand, everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But learn how to do. And also, if you praise Allah as much as you can, and the whole human being and the jinn praise Allah and say, Alhamdulillah, 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 Alhamdulillah. Let me give you an example as it is mentioned here. If the whole trees of the whole earth become pen or a pencil, and the ink of this pen is the oceans of the whole land and the sea. The water of the sea, the water of the ocean become an ink for the pen. And this pen is the come out of the whole trees of the land. And in order to write, they have to have a sheet. And the sheet is the whole heavens and the earth. To write the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And who's saying, whole human being and whole jinn. Saying to the one who write the praise of Allah. It will be enough to thank Allah? No. To thank the favors of Allah upon you? No. Is it will be enough? It will not be enough. The greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, higher than that. And the favor of Allah upon you, unlimited and uncountable. One favor itself contains too many. Like your own eye. One is not two. Your own eye, one eye. Too many favors of Allah upon that. But the one who will know that is the one who loses it. The one who doesn't lose it, yes, is for him something very normal. He doesn't know what it is. You have a teeth. You will know that you have a teeth when you have a pain. I have one. And it is have a problem in it. But it is with you already 40 years before, 50 years before. You don't feel about it. And this is wrong. It's not right. Be thankful to Allah. Because some of us only will look to the little bit hardship or little bit test. They will forget everything. Then they will talk to Allah as if they talk to somebody with them. Astaghfirullah. Blaming Allah. Should not. La ilaha illa huwa. None has the right to be worshipped. And perfect worship should be done. Except for Him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your creator. Who created for you the ears and the eyes? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who make you to speak different languages? Allah, if you want this tongue to be stopped, will stop. And you will not be able to do anything. And the whole human being and the whole medicine will never be benefit you. Who teach you the knowledge you have is not you. Allah Azza wa Jalla is the one who gives it to you. Allah Azza wa Jalla is the one who gives you the knowledge you have. It's not by your, I am smart. No. The money you have is not because you are smart. It's not because I'm working hard. Because this is what we say always. Look, brother, I'm working 20 years hard. No, it's not because you are working. Some people, they work harder than you, 40 years. They don't get nothing. Allah is the one who gives. And Allah is the one who makes you to work also. And Allah is the one who makes you to have the reasons of what you have. Everything belongs to Allah Azza wa Jal, but you have to know that. This is a should be the aqeedah of the Muslim. Your belief. Who gives a life? Allah Azza wa Jal. Who takes the soul? Allah Azza wa Jal. Who makes you to sleep? And if you want to take your soul while you're sleeping, Allah will take it. Who make you to wake up after you sleep? Allah Azza wa Jalla. If you have sickness, who can remove it? Not the medicine. Not the doctors. Yes, they have the reasons. Who gives them the reason? Allah. Shifa in hand of Allah. For that when you ask for shifa, ask. Allah Azza wa Jalla only. Because this is something in hand of Allah alone. And if you ask other than Allah, like wali in the graves, we are not denying their own position. We are not denying their own nearness to Allah. No, we are denying what you are doing for them. And them themselves, if Allah wakes them up from their grave, wallahi, by Allah, they will deny if they are really wali. They will deny what you are doing. They will deny the shirk you do because themselves was very near to Allah. They didn't know what you are doing now. At their lives, there was nothing like that. Who make you to, after you being hungry, to feel satisfied? Allah Azza wa Jal. Otherwise, you could be eating millions and nothing. Still you feel hungry. وَلَعَذُ بِاللَّهِ وَأَسْكَ اللَّهِ سَيْفَ Say Ameen. When you feel thirsty, who makes the water? Allah. Who give it to you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are poor, a test for you. And if you are rich, another test for you. Who make you poor? Allah. For a wisdom behind it. But you have to know it. Suppose, I don't know it. Believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. And depend upon Him and trust Him. He will make you rich. Suppose He doesn't make you rich. For a wisdom behind it. There is some hikmah behind it. Make you also rich. It is a test. What will you do when you are poor? What will you do when you are rich? Will you use the money for Allah or use it for everything other than Allah? Also, happiness in hand of Allah Azza wa Jal only. Being happy and removing your sadness, removing your worry, removing your calamities in hand of Allah Azza wa Jal. The greatness of Allah, not only in the human being, Even in the animals, as I said, who makes the snakes and the reptiles, some of them, walking upon their own bellies? Allah Azza wa Jal. Who make the human being woke up to Allah Azza wa Jal, who makes the animals like the cow and the lions and the tigers woken up on four. If Allah won't ask, we woke up on four. You see some of the human being in the open, very far desert from the whole life, they walk till now upon the four, their hand and their legs. Human being. Whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who do everything by the way he wants. Who makes a bird to fly at the sky and stop, making his wings like that. Look to some of the eagles and some of the different bird. You will find them stop like that. Who stop him like this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But think about it. The reptiles, also the animals in general. Some animals, very kind, very nice, you can live with it, you can bring it in your home, cats. Or same kind sometime, impossible to come even near to it. Very dangerous. Wild. Some of the cats, yeah, wild. Some of it, very peaceful, but some of it, very dangerous. Not only in the land, even in the sea. You look to the sea, you will find, Subhanallah, another يعني, world, completely different than ours. Just to bring one of it out of the water, few minutes, gone, die. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of it live in the water and live in the land, both. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, glory be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the creation of Allah with a feather, some of it with the wool. Who makes the feather? Who makes the wool? Who makes the hair? Goats, different than, sheep, different than bird. This is with the feather. This is with the wool. This is with the hair. Glory be to Him, Subhanahu wa Taala. For that, إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ. If you ask Allah Azza wa Jalla alone. وَإِذَا اسْتَعَنْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. And if you seek help from Allah Azza wa Jal alone. احفظ الله يحفظ. Be loyal to Allah. What I mean by the greatness of Allah, be loyal to Him, know Him, love Him, be connected to Him, be with Him, He will be with you. Be loyal to Allah, Allah will be with you, Allah will protect you, Allah will help you, Allah will support you, Allah will aid you. But not only at the time of hardship. Be with Allah all the time. Especially at the time of ease. If you are in an easy time and happy time, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will be with you in the hardship you have. And be patient, have some sabr. Example of that in Surah As-Saffat, Surah number 37, ayah number 144. Sayyidina Yunus. When the big fish, the whale, swallow him. Just right away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبَعَثُونَ. Had, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, had he, Yunus, not been of those who glorify Allah. At the time of calamity, he remembered Allah Azza wa Jal. And he gloried, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. Oh Allah, I was wrong. Right away, confess to Allah, not to nobody. To Allah Azza wa Jal. Right away, he remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah say, if it is not, he was being glorified Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, recognize and know that he was doing something, did something Allah doesn't want it, Allah doesn't like it. Allah said, if he does not, he would have indeed remain inside the belly of the fish till the day of judgment. He will indeed, Allah is able to do whatever He wants. How? Allah knows. Allah say, we believe in it. He say, He could be, remain in the belly of the fish till the day of judgment. Look how it is, subhanAllah. For that, if you are in a calamity, remember Allah Azza wa Jal right away. Go back to Allah. People will never do nothing to you. And if they do wrong most of the time. إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبِّي. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you really sincerely to Him, connected to Him, depend upon Him, and He's calling you to enter al-Jannah. Every single second. وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُو إِلَى دَارِ السَّلَامِ. Allah calling you to enter. دَارِ السَّلَامِ الْجَنَّةِ. وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُو إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ.
according to the Jannah. In the last third part of the night, from after 12 o'clock and going until the Fajr, till 5 or 6 o'clock at the morning, Allah come down to the sky of ours. And He's saying, هَلْ مِنْ سَائِلٍ فَأُعْطِيَهُ. Greatness of Allah. With this greatness, He come to you. He say, is there anyone who ask anything, I'll give it to him. هَلْ مِنْ مُسْتَغْفِرٍ فَأَغْفِرَ لَهُ. Is there anyone who ask him forgiveness, I'll forgive him. هَلْ مِنْ تَائِبٍ فَأَتُوبَ عَلَيْهِ. Is there anyone who do repentance? I will give him the repentance and accept it from him. Rasulullah say, كُلُّ أُمَّتِي يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا مَنْ أَبَى. All of my ummah will enter al-jannah. Except the one who refused. They said, Ya Rasulullah, is there anyone who will refuse? He said, yes. Whoever obey me, obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the one who will enter al-jannah. And whoever refuse, is the one who refused to enter al-jannah. من أطاعني دخل الجنة ومن عصاني فقد أبى. Whoever obey me will enter al-jannah. Whoever disobey me, this is the one who refused. And he will not enter al-jannah. Allah Azza wa Jal say, O son of Adam, even if you do full of the earth mistakes, full of the earth, wrong and haram and bad, but you come sincerely to Allah and ask Allah forgiveness and you hope of the mercy of Allah and the forgiveness of Allah. The hadith it says, لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا, the whole earth full of wrong from you. But you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, does not have and commit any kind of shirk. In this hadith also, and it's important of learning the halaqat of shirk. You come in front of Allah because look, shirk not according to your mind. According to your mind, worshipping everything other than Allah is okay. Some of the people, not all, have no problem at all. They worship the grave thinking that they are doing the best, which it is in Islam not. Not only the grave, are you ready? More than 3 years now explaining about what kind of shirk we have and how many types. How many types in the saying and in the doing and in the a'mal of the qalb, action of the heart. It could be contained shirk while you don't know. Because it's so يعني, hidden. More than a black ant in a very dark night and upon a very smooth rock. You will not feel it, you will not hear it, you will not, except if you learn. When you learn, this hadith of Allah Azza wa Jal, that if you come to me with all kind of mistake, full of the earth, but not shirk, I will forgive you. Allah Azza wa Jal say exactly, لَأَتَيْتُكَ بِقُرَابِهَا مَغْفِرَةً. I will meet you with full of the land, forgiveness. You bring it to Allah and come to Allah full of the land, wrong. Allah will bring it to you full of the land, but without shirk. If you do not commit shirk, full of the land, forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His greatness, forgiver of all kind of sin. But He already decided, not shirk. He subhanahu wa ta'ala stretched His hand at the night, every night, for the one who do mistakes at the day to repent. And also stretched His hand at the day. Same hadith. وَيَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ بِالنَّهَارُ لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ اللَّيْلِ. And He stretched His hand at the daytime for the one who do mistake at the night. And this is hatta tatlu al-shams min maghribaha, till the sun, instead of coming of the east, will come from the west, no more. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ghaffarun liman tab, forgiver to the one who do tawbah. We know the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the man who killed 100 people. 100 he killed. 100 people he killed. And he do tawbah, real tawbah. And he was asking, look to the listening. They listen. First, he asked a wrong man and he gave him wrong fatwa, he killed him also. It was actually 99, then finished. Khalas, 100. And he went a real alim. Is there any tawbah for me? He said, who can prevent you from tawbah and who can take it away from you? But only just the people you are with them is a bad people. Leave them and go to that village or that city or that town. Have a good people. They will help you to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was really doing real good intention, real and good tawbah, repentance to Allah, returning to Him, feel regret and sad and bad about what he already did, and he have intention never to do it, while in his way, his death, time of death come. Angel of Rahman, angel of Azab, come. Angel of Rahmah, taking the soul very easy, angel of Azab take it very hardly. And they said, the angel of Azab, they said, he killed 100. The other angel, they said, but he did a tawbah. Allah sent another angel to judge between both of them. Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. He said to them, measure the land between him and the bad land. And measure the land between him to the good land. And which it is, he is near to it, he will belong to. If he is near to the evil land, he will be with the evil people. If he is near to the good land, he will be with the good people. Look to the greatness of Allah. Allah make the land to be short and make him near to the good land, to the good people, good town or good city or good village, whatever it is, until it become only one span, and make the other one very far, for that the angel of Rahmah take his soul. But really he did a real tawbah, real sincerely tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to us, not only that man who killed 100, you remember when a man came in front of Allah with a 99 book of record, huge book of record, all of it full of mistakes. All of it, not even a single one good deed in it. But a small bitaqa, a small card, La ilaha illallah. He was not a mushrik. He knows what is La ilaha illallah, and he do according to it. Angel was going to take him to hell. Allah said, wait, wait, he has this card. He himself in the hadith, saying, oh Allah, what will this small one do with 99 and cannot see the end? Cannot see the end of it. 99 book of records, so huge. What will this small one will do with it? Allah says there is no injustice. Good. He put it in one balance, in one side, and all the 99 in one side, La ilaha illallah, none has the right to be worshipped other than Allah Azza wa Jal alone, Tawheed, Islamic monotheism, heavier than anything else. When it both become heavier than all, and he was admitted to Jannah. Greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But really know him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, when you do tawbah, Allah give example in another hadith. In another hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you do tawbah, Allah will be more happier than the one who lost his camel and food in the desert, then he find it all of a sudden. How happy he will be. So happy. Allah more happier than that one if you do tawbah to him and return to him and go back to him subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah said about Rasulullah, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allah will not give them punishment in general and public, يعني punishment to all of them as long as you, means Rasulullah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in them. And he say, and I will never punish them publicly. Publicly means on all, together, as long as they ask forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you count the ni'mat of Allah upon you, you will never be able to count it. You will never. Because favor of Allah and the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you in everything. Everything you see, everything you touch, everything you hear, everything you taste, everything you smell. Have a lot of favor, every single one of that. In your tongue, in your body, in your eyes, in your ears, in your hand. A lot of favor of Allah in your legs. A lot of favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your talking. A lot of favor of Allah upon your brain. A lot of favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of your thinking. A lot of favor of Allah to you about your heart. A one problem in your heart that could make all of your body suffering. A lot of favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the food he's giving you. A lot of favor of the clothes. A lot of favor of the riding and transportation. Millions of different kinds of transportation. Trains and planes and ship and cars and buses. And under the ground and over the face of the ground and over your head, many bridges. Subhanallah. Favor of Allah. At the same time, we are not thankful. About your houses. Favor of Allah upon you. Your own kids. Think about it. Favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your own wife. And for the wife, your own husband. While you are waking and while you are sleeping, favor of Allah upon you. While you are standing, while you are sitting, while you are working, while you're in the air, while you are in the land, while you are even in the water, favor of Allah upon you, in your money, in a lot, in your shape. He teach you whatever you never ever know. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, glory be to him. Giving you rizq from all different kind. Accepting your dua. But if you do it, send to us the Quran, one of the biggest of the favor, that you are a Muslim. And he sent to us the Quran al-Kareem. And he teach us sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, calling you to al-Jannah. Allah Azza wa Jal saying, amazing for you, son of Adam. I create you and you worship other than me. I create you. And instead of worship the one who created you, no, you worship other than him. And also, Allah say, I give you rizq and you are thankful to other than me. I try to be kind with you and nice to you and I come near to you and you try to be far from me. Even I don't need you. Allah Azza wa Jal saying that. أتحببوا إليك بالنعم وأنا غني عنك وتتبغضوا إلي بالمعاصي. He tried to come near to you and make you to obey him. At the same time, you disobey and you become far. وأنت فقير إلي. فقير. Allah says, you are a poor and you are in need of me. خيري إليك نازل وشرك إلي صاعد. My favor and my goodness coming down always upon you, and your evil and your bad deeds and your disbelief coming up to me. Allah is so patient, and this is part of His greatness. We are in the land 7 billion. Imagine if the 7 billion, everyone do only one mistake a day, one wrong, one disobeying. 7 billion mistake and wrong and haram done daily against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Goes to Allah up, while still He is giving all of what I mentioned and more. I said at the beginning of this halaqat, it will never ever be enough. But at least some better than nothing. In Surah Al-Balad, Surah number 90, Ayah number 8, Allah Azza wa Jal said, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. Didn't we make to him two eyes, tongue, two lips, and shown him the two ways, the good and evil. Allah showed it to us. And He gave you a freedom, no force. InshaAllah, the next time will come more with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving us. And about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And about the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma gfir lana dhunubana. Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar. Allahumma arihna wa afrihna wa asturna wa la tafdahna. ويسر لنا أمورنا واشرح لنا صدورنا واغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار وأعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك واهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزانا وجزاكم الله خيرا. I'm asking you by the great name of Allah, always remember us in the best of your dua, and the angel will return the same dua to you. وجزانا وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.